नेक्स्ट इंपॉर्टेंट लेसन इज ओलियम गैस लीक. ओलियम गैस लीक केस इज ऑल्सो नोन एज एमसी मेहता वर्सेज यूनियन ऑफ इंडिया. बिटवीन 4th एंड 6th डिसंबर 1985 देर वेर टू सक्सेसिव लीक्स ऑफ ओलियम गैस फ्रॉम अ यूनिट ऑफ श्रीराम फूड्स एंड फर्टिलाइजर इंडस्ट्रीज. मीन्स दिस ओलियम गैस वॉज लीक्ड फ्रॉम दिस यूनिट श्रीराम फूड्स एंड फर्टिलाइजर इंडस्ट्रीज एंड देर वेर टू सक्सेसिव लीक्स अफेक्टिंग मेनी पीपल इंक्लूडिंग द डेथ ऑफ एन एडवोकेट इन द हार्ट ऑफ कैपिटल सिटी ऑफ इंडिया मीन्स इन दिल्ली. दिस वॉज द सेकेंड वर्स्ट डिजास्टर आफ्टर द भोपाल गैस ट्रेजडी. MC Mehta brought attention of government and parliament to this issue. He was an environmentalist advocate. He filed a PIL on this issue. PIL means public interest litigation. In this public interest is there. He claimed compensation for the victims. Shriram Food Fertilizer urged for restarting the industry on grounds of unemployment, economic loss to the company and storage of chlorine to Delhi water supply under water supply, water taking. Supreme Court felt that the experts should be present in the committee because the advocates don't have the knowledge of how much quantity oleum gas should be there and how chlorine should be used and how employment is raised. So here we need the experts to solve these problems. So it is felt that experts should be there in the committee to solve such cases. So first time court felt that it is a complex and difficult case. First issue was, now first what is the issue? It is about the compensation should be given to the victims by industry. And second issue was of the unemployment which was also related to the public. Third issue was chlorine production was stopped because Shriram industry was the one industry. It was the only to produce the chlorine production. The Supreme Court wanted to balance this condition. For balancing the condition, court established of a neutral scientific expertise service. In this, nor governor, petitioners, courts will not interfere in this. This committee will work neutrally and collect the information and will help the court. So the expert committee was set up. Now here, two epistolary jurisdiction was adopted and suggestions were given. Epistolary means letter. Epistolary jurisdiction means acting on letter written by or on behalf of the oppressed people. So here two epistolary jurisdiction was adopted and suggestions were given. Setting up of environmental courts or regional basis was suggested. Now the question is always asked from this case that what are the three suggestions given by the court. First suggestion is, means on this case, first suggestion is whenever there is such a difficult situation, then expert committee should be established or appointed. Any individual can file the case in the interest of public, means PIL. And third suggestion is setting up of environmental courts on regional basis was suggested. This is a very important question. Always it is asked that what are the three suggestions given by the court related to this case. So first time in India, environmental justice was given importance and compensation should be also given to the environment. Compensation like when industries let their outlet in rivers, oceans, then they must first purify or remove the harmful material from it. The Bhagwati court deserves appreciation for giving a call to build up an Indian engro jurisprudence. And secondly, the principle Reland versus Fletcher was used. Supreme Court has repeatedly ruled it as for one land on a law should be there, means one land on a law should be there. The government passed Environment Protection Act 1986. We came to know that human beings are not enemy of human being but also of environment. So such laws should be set up. So here we see the three important deaths from this case. Bhopal gas tragedy in 1984, then oleum gas leak in 1985, and Environmental Protection Act was passed in 1986. 1984, 1985, 1986. So here we have completed the lesson, the case, oleum gas leak.